Now let us move to the next step. After having completed about the health aspects of the alimentary canal, now let us move to the diseases due to malnutrition. So what do you mean by malnutrition? So taking the food not containing proper nutrients. So generally we know that we need to take the food containing different type of the nutrients. So that can be carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins, and minerals. So these particular food materials which are there, we are taking in the form of food. So these are the nutrients. So carbohydrates, proteins, fats are called macronutrients. Vitamins and minerals are called micronutrients. So we call carbohydrates, proteins, fats as macronutrients because we take in large quantity in our day-to-day life. And vitamins and minerals, so are the simple food nutrients which we take in very small micrograms. That is why they are called as micronutrients, right? And whenever we are taking a food containing carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins and minerals in the required quantity, right? So that is called as balanced diet. So we call it as a balanced diet. Quite opposite to that. So when a person takes the food not containing proper nutrients, that can be any one of the nutrients, then such a type of the intake of the food, so leads to a problem called as malnutrition problem. Once again, eating the food not containing one or more than one nutrients in our regular diet is called as malnutrition. So there are different causes for malnutrition, right? First cause, that is poor health conditions. So by birth itself, if the child is not healthy enough, so the child might not be able to consume the food properly. So the poor health conditions also leads to malnutrition. So this is the very first cause we have got. Then second cause leading, that second is socio-economic conditions. So where there are families where they are not able to feed the children properly, so this particular factor plays a major important role in leading to malnutrition. Socio-economic factors, so especially the children who are coming, are families which are below the poverty line, they may not be able to provide their children the proper food. So that also leads to the malnutrition, right? Next, coming to willful starvation. So purposefully, so whenever we are not taking the food at the proper timing, balanced food if we are not taking containing all the nutrients also will lead to this problem called as malnutrition. Then next, coming to lastly, lack of awareness. So people, those who do not have proper nutritional awareness about the nutritional habits, that is what type of food is to be given for a child of 1 year, 2 years, 10 years, 15 years, so if they are not having such a type of the awareness, what type of food materials we have to give, so that also leads to the malnutrition problem. So lack of awareness is also one of the reasons for the malnutrition problem, right? Now moving to the types of malnutrition. So there are three different types of malnutrition. So first type of the malnutrition is called as calorie malnutrition. Second type of the malnutrition is called as protein malnutrition. Third type of the malnutrition is called as protein calorie malnutrition. Malnutrition means deficiency of nutrients. If calories, that is generally we know that we are taking carbohydrates, proteins and fats as our major food. So that is why they are called macronutrients. Vitamins and minerals we are taking in minor quantity, less quantity, and these nutrients do not require any digestion, easily they are absorbed. But the complex molecules like carbohydrates, proteins and fats compulsively do require the digestion process, and a particular enzyme is required to break down the complex carbohydrates, proteins and fats into simpler substances, right? And the purpose of taking carbohydrates and fats into our body is energy production. The purpose of taking the proteins in our body is body building, right? And the energy which is produced by taking carbohydrates and fats, it is measured in calories. So when there is a deficiency of intake of carbohydrates and fats, then the type of the malnutrition is called as, or if the food we take does not contain required quantity of carbohydrates and fats, then the type of the nutrition is called a calorie malnutrition, right? Now moving to the second one, protein malnutrition. The word itself very clearly indicates that there is a deficiency of proteins. If the child is not given required quantity of the proteins, then the child is said to be suffering from a problem called as protein malnutrition, right? And the last type of the malnutrition is called protein calorie malnutrition. So this is because of the deficiency of two type of components, carbohydrates, fats, and as well as the proteins. Protein calorie malnutrition, deficiency of carbohydrates and fats, deficiency of proteins, together it is called protein calorie malnutrition. So like this, we have got three different types of the malnutrition. Now let us move to the next part, that is diseases related to malnutrition. So basically here we are going to study two different type of the diseases due to malnutrition. The first type of the disease we have got is called as kwashiorkor, and these diseases were first identified in Africa. So many countries in Africa, so countries, very poor countries, so their children are lagging, and these diseases are popularly found in children below 5 years, where children are not given good diet, good proper food. So such a type of diseases are most common. So these were first identified in African countries, right? So kwashiorkor, right? Now first type of the disease, malnutrition disease, is called kwashiorkor. This is an example for deficiency of proteins in the food. If the food given to the child does not contain required quantities of proteins, then the deficiency leads to a disease called as kwashiorkor. So what are the symptoms for this disease? So here we have got swollen body parts, right? The child is found to be with swollen body parts. Why it is due to? Because of the intercellular spaces are filled with water, and due to the accumulation of the water in the intercellular spaces, the body parts appearance will be swollen. Hands and legs will be swollen, and very poor muscle development. So the, because already we know that the proteins are meant for body growth, so muscular development will not be there. That is what we call very poor muscle development. Apart from this, the child appearance, face appearance will be very ugly. Okay, moon shaped appearance will be there. It is called fluffy face. Then next, one more symptom we have got, the skin. Generally, children skin will be very soft. Young children skin will be very soft. But because the child is now said to be suffering with a protein deficiency problem, so the child's skin will be very dry, and that is called dry skin. And the child is very often said to be suffering with a problem called diarrhea. So that is vomiting and motions. And the child finds very difficult in eating. So small quantities of the food is to be given, and it's a situation where the child will not be able to accept the food. So it's a problem in taking the food, difficulty to eat. So these are the different type of the symptoms related to kwashiorkor. So which is an example for protein malnutrition. Protein malnutrition, example kwashiorkor disease. Now moving to the second type of the disease, malnutrition diseases, marasmus, right? So this is an example for protein calorie malnutrition. It is an example for shortage of the proteins and as well as the calories. So it is an example for protein calorie malnutrition. So now moving to what are the different reasons for our reasons and symptoms of kwashiorkor. So reason is repeated childbirths. Whenever a lady is going for the repeated childbirths, so giving a very little gap between the first child and the second child, that is what we call immediate second pregnancy. So if the proper feeding is not given to the first child, then the child is said to be suffering with a disease, marasmus. So weaned out, the child is said to be weaned out from the mother. So what do you mean by weaned out? Separated from mother's milk. So once the child is of almost 1.5 years, so the child is to be fed with the mother's milk almost up to 2 years. So immediately there is a second pregnancy, second childbirth, then there is a negligence shown in the food to be given to the first child. So that's what reasons we say repeated childbirths or immediate second pregnancy is the major problem for this particular disease called as marasmus, and the first child is weaned out, separated from the mother's milk. Now the child finds a difficulty in getting the proteins required, proteins and calories. So it is called protein calorie malnutrition. That is, the disease is called marasmus. Then what sort of symptoms we have got in this particular disease? So the child is the child appears to be very lean and weak. Okay, so there will be no energy production, lean and weak. So here proteins are meant for bodybuilding and calories are meant for, that is, energy production. So the child does not have proper muscular development and no energy production in the body. So So lean and weak appearance of the child. Then next, same symptoms, we almost the same type of the symptoms we can see in these two type of the diseases, right? So the one more symptom here we have, what is diarrhea. So having vomiting and motions, that is the diarrhea problem here. Then next, dry skin is the one more common symptom we have, and poor muscle development. So these are the things. Then how to avoid this particular marasmus? So we need to give a proper gap between the child, first child and second child, so that the first child is justified and given proper food by the mother. So then we can avoid such a type of the disease called as marasmus. And these two diseases, whether it can be kwashiorkor or marasmus, are not permanent diseases. If the child is given required quantities of proteins, then we can avoid kwashiorkor disease. If the child is given required quantities of proteins and calories, then we can avoid the marasmus disease, right? Finally, now moving to one more disease, that is obesity. So these two diseases are because of the deficiency of the nutrients, but this is not because of the deficiency of nutrients. This is because of the excess of nutrients. What sort of nutrients are excess? If any person takes more than required fats, then the excess intake of the fats will lead to a problem called as obesity problem. Obesity problem. Then how does it enter into our body? So nowadays we are habituated to take different types of the oily foods more. Okay, our junk food, what we call pizzas and burgers, such type of food. So which contain excess of fats not required for the body. And when taken, if exercise is not given properly to the body, then the accumulation of the fats takes place in the body and leads to obesity. So excess of calories we are taking in the body will lead to obesity problem. And this particular obesity is a great health hazard. So it leads to several complications. So we get complications like cardiovascular problems, heart related problems. Okay, then apart from that, we have got gallbladder problems and renal problems. So to overcome all these, so stones formation in the gallbladder and stones formation in the kidneys, etc. So all such type of problems, so we have to come across if you are taking excess fats. So it's not good to take excess fats. So this is what we have got about the obesity.